So Lovable just launched its 2.0 version, and there are quite a few things. In fact, these features have been rolled out over time to the users, and some of us has been using these features for some time now. I'm going to play this video, but before that, I'm going to show you some of the things that I have built using Lovable and other softwares, or just completely using Lovable. This is a software that I started building in Lovable and took it to Cursor and turned it into something like this. And some other things like this one, which is a very simple application that was completely built in lovable.dev. Okay, so I'm going to come to all of this later on, but let's have a look at this video. First of all, I'm just going to play it. Okay. Really cool animations, but yeah. So this is a feature that is just amazing. Like, you can work with your team and edit. I've actually covered this in a previous video, but really saves time and money. It saves money specifically. And domain right from Lovable. You need a paid plan for it. And you can edit your code inside of Lovable itself. And again, you need... Okay, so let's go to Lovable. This is a project that I was building, and this is the same project as this one. So this is how it was in Lovable, and I changed the UI, but it is completely functional here. I'll show you that. But before that, if you see some of the things that they mentioned, so this is the invite button. So you can invite by email and you can collaborate with them using this. Obviously, you need a paid plan for this one. Okay, same thing with the code. You can look at the code here and you can edit it. And for that, you obviously need the paid plan for editing as well. Okay, you have this option here, which is the edit button, which is available for everyone, which literally saves tons of money for everyone, because sometimes you just want to change the name of the app and you had to go in and prompt for it, and that would cost. But instead, now I can just click on this edit button here. Okay, it's relaunching it, and I can select these things and change stuff. If I want to change the text, I can change the text, change the margin, padding, font size. If I want to increase it to like 9XL, so it is large now. So I can just keep it to this. I'm just going to keep it to XL, I guess. Okay. And we can change all these things. You can change the colors, font weight, and all of that can be changed. I'm going to go with extra bold, and this is how it looks. And then I can save it or discard it. So that's a very, very good feature. And most importantly, there is something else, that is, if you just go to settings, you can now have domains. Again, you need the paid plan. You can add your own domain, or you can buy a domain from Lovable itself. Okay. So that actually eases the whole thing up. Deploying becomes easier. Even though you know nothing about coding and deploying, you can create an app in Lovable and then deploy it on the web with a custom URL. Okay, so that's the great thing right now. So I'm actually going to show you what this application does. What it does is actually helps me automate the whole faceless video creation process. So for example, I'm just going to click on this select image button here, and I'm going to click here, and I'm going to actually just, let's say, drag and drop in all these images in. All that has come in, and the timing is set here. If I upload an audio, okay, I'm going to upload this audio, for example. Okay, now this timing has been set based on the length of this audio. Okay, and if I play this, you will see that these images has scaling animation automatically added, and these images has been stacked one after the other in the edit till the end of the video. Okay, so if I just play it just for a bit.
The profound wisdom of the Upanishads, composed thousands of years ago, finds striking parallels in today's scientific understanding of reality.
Look, you can see that one after the other, these images come up and they have these scaling animations. Okay, and then I can export it as an MP4. I also went ahead and added some effects to this, but then once it did give me a tab here, the next time around, it just added all those effects downwards. And then I started feeling like the UI was confusing and it was already 10 prompts here. So I just thought I'll just export it from here, take it to GitHub like this, and then import this repo into Cursor. And then that was turned into this application. Okay, it does the same thing. If I just refresh this page here, this now has a lot more features. I can add the media from here. Unlike earlier, now I can also add video. So for example, I'll add a video here. This is an MP4 file. I'm going to add that. Okay, then I'm going to once again add a lot of images. Okay, and then if I go to this one, add audio, I'm going to add the same audio that I added there. Okay, and you can see that now I can see it in a timeline. Okay, and you also have this video. So if I just play it, okay.
The profound wisdom of the Upanishads.
So the video plays,
thousands of years
and
ago,
then
finds
the
parallels in today's scientific understanding
images
of reality.
Animation starts as well. Not just that, I added few other things. So for example, I added these effects. So I can add this vignette effect, okay? Change the value. So this is a high vignette effect. I can add sepia effect if I want. I can add those effects. There is grayscale, black and white, blur. And most importantly, I wanted something like this, where I can add some kind of an effect, like a scratch effect like this, and then change it to something like screen. And then if I play it, you can see that effect on top of that. And obviously I can control it and I can stack it up. So if I want to add more, I can add another effect. I'm going to add this. I can upload a video, something like a film grain. Okay. And then here I am going to select multiply and reduce the opacity. And if I play this, you can see there is that film grain and those scratch effect that has been added. So all of this I was able to do because I got an app that was functional from here, from Lovable. To start this kind of an app in Cursor for someone like me who doesn't know how to code or have any kind of developer experience would be really, really hard because I've tried these things before, but to start in Cursor is really hard. So if you have ambitious projects like this, and this is not the end of it, I'm going to make sure that this application is a full-featured app where you can write the script, you can do the voiceover, you can do create the images, and then edit and export it out from here. So right now, the reason I'm focusing here is because I do have an app that I built which creates long-form audio generation. It has voices from 11 Labs, it has voices from Minimax, it has voices from PlayHST, all of it in one single app. And it is really designed to create long form audio files. And I also have another app which creates 100 images at the same time. I can input 100 prompts and click one button, and in 5 to 10 seconds, I will have 100 images generated. So it becomes easy because I have those softwares. I can import the images together and the audio generated and then easily create these videos. But what I want to do is to expand this, those features. I want to bring it into this software and turn it into one software where everything can be done, including script creation. Okay, so that's an ambitious project, but that's one way of using Lovable. You can also use it to literally solve a small problem. So for example, let's say I'm creating this video and I want to add captions. Okay, so I go into this Premiere Pro, and here, once I create this caption, some of these words in the script has Sanskrit or some other language, for example. Okay, and the transcription doesn't get those words right. So what I need to do is I actually have to replace the transcription with the original script. And Premiere Pro allows you to do that. You can import the corrected transcript as a TXT file. Okay. So the problem was that, let's say I import this script. I will go in here. I'm going to say, let's say this is the script. Okay. And if I copy these things and turn that into a TXT file, create a TXT file, and then import that into Premiere and upload it from here. The problem is that these words will go up and down occasionally, and sometimes even leave some dots. And the reason for that is these spaces. Wherever there is this space, it will leave some gaps. So that creates a bit of an issue with the caption. It won't be in the same line throughout the video. So it has to stay like this. It doesn't. Sometimes it will be here. Sometimes it will be here because of the gap. So when you import that, it brings in those gaps as well. So that's a problem. So the solution for that is to actually go in individually and make sure that I remove this gap and then turn it into a single block of text. Now, this would take anywhere from 5 to 10 minutes for a script which has like 5,000 to 8,000 words, right? So it's going to take time, and it's boring and it's time consuming, and it might not take a long time. Really, really irritating. So I had this problem, so I had to solve it. So I just created this simple application. I can just copy this text from here. And this was completely created in Lovable. So all I have to do is paste this text in here. You can see the gaps here. That has been turned into a single block of text without any gap. So I can just copy it from here, create a TXT file. In fact, I didn't think about it at that point in time. Now, when I think about it, maybe I should have asked Lovable to also give me a TXT file so that that whole problem is also solved of creating the TXT file. But this really saves a lot of time and a lot of frustrating moments for me. Something very simple as that, but it solves a problem that I have. So if you want to create simple softwares like this, which legitimately solves some of the problems that you're facing in your day-to-day work, you can easily create them in Lovable, right? So this is an incredible software. And with all the new features, you can do a lot more. And I've also noticed that they're saying that it is more intelligent. And you can actually see too, I don't think building this app would have been easier a little earlier, but now it just like in 10 prompts. In fact, in the second prompt, I was able to get it to work. Okay. So I obviously the idea evolved. Initially, it was just like get the images together. That's all that I was looking for. But then I was like, okay, if that is happening, then I can try and get the timing to match the audio. So as it evolved, and I now have this application, which is, you know, which I'm so proud of it. So, and I think I can really build it into something really, really strong. Obviously, there's a lot to do here because I realized that when I export it, I cannot change the tab because if I do, because it is using the browser's Canvas API, something to render these things, I cannot change the tabs while the rendering is happening. Maybe I'll have to push it to some other service to do it in the background and stuff like that. I'm learning those things because I don't know all that. Maybe I can ask Cursor to do it, but because I don't know the processes, it might be really hard for me to see when it makes a mistake. So I'm also learning those things. I'm not necessarily learning to code. What I'm doing is to maybe follow someone who is doing something. So there are a lot of videos on YouTube itself where they are creating a full application from start to end. So I'm just going through those things, maybe replicating that so that I can learn the processes, how to manage the backend, how to do the database, how to, when you're rendering, what do you do actually? The process is happening, but there are limitations as of now. So I need to solve all of those problems so that I can work with it and also maybe later on sell it to others as SaaS, because this could really make the whole faceless video creation process very, very easy and straightforward. And for someone who doesn't know anything about editing, also can do this kind of a thing. I obviously have to add captions to this and I'm working on that, but this is what it is. So you can create either simple problem-solving applications, and you can do that completely in lovable.dev, or you could create something like this. You get the foundation and the functionalities right in Lovable, and then bring it to something like Cursor and design it like this. Okay, so I absolutely love this design, and you know, it took some time to figure this out, create all these small tabs that I've created that will hold all these effects and media files and stuff like that. I can even expand it, actually close this whole window. And so it's a very, very reactive app. And yeah, so that is what is possible. And I'm saying start if you feel like you are lagging behind. Stop doing a lot of research, but just start. Start creating stuff. It will just happen, right? So this is probably my third video editing app that I've built. Each of those are doing different things. Rather than stuffing it all up with a lot of features, I'm not adding any kind of editing, cutting, combining features here. It's all done in the back end. Okay. So to be frank, whatever you got here is what you are getting there. This was happening completely in the background. There I can see it. That is the only difference. Here I can see it. I have a bit of a thing with these kind of interfaces, and it makes me feel really, really happy about it. So I think when you're building something, it also have to satisfy your own ideas or whatever, you know. So that is about it. I just didn't want to make videos about this feature is there, that feature is there. I really wanted to also build stuff and show this to others that these things are possible even for non-developers like me. So you can also do it. So that's it for this video. If you'd like to watch more content like this, want to follow more AI related content, please subscribe to the channel, like this video, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in the next one.